So once you have the PDF imported into Business Center, and usually when it's a one pager, automatically you get the place image command open. What is a place image? It's basically stretching up the PDF to match the scale, so then you can utilize information from the PDF for your digitizing, for your takeoffs, or if you just need to pull some dimensions or whatnot. So usually what I do, I take a quick peek at the north arrow. This instance, the north arrow is pointing straight up, which is great. That not necessarily happens, you know, a whole bunch of drawings are skewed. So you can definitely utilize that information. Then the next thing is, sometimes you have scale bar. This one doesn't have it, so I would go inspect. Sometimes you have the property line dimensions or azimuths. If you don't, there is most likely a dimension somewhere. For example, right now here is the 2066, here is 921. Is there another approach? No. So that's pretty okay for now. You can always go into architectural drawing and pull the dimension of your building or whatnot. For this, we're just gonna utilize this 2066. So on the right hand side, you have three ways of placing an image. You can do it by known distance, you can do it with line with distance and bearing, and scale bar and known bearing. So let's go try and do the known distance. So we know the distance is 20.66, and it's asking us from pixel. So I'm gonna click on this one, 2 pixel, and as you can see, this is a vector PDF, so it's snapping directly to the line, assigning the pixels some coordinates. Once I hit compute, the PDF will scale. So if I hit the measure, and I'll just kind of pull roughly from here to here, I should be around 921, and look at that, 921. So I would assume this drawing was scaled properly. I have some 3 meters here, 3 meters here. Yeah, 3.14, it depends where I click, right? Obviously, I clicked a little bit more here and a little bit more here. Yeah, 3.1, not the best, but will do, depending on for what you wanna use it. This one is, it's here. It's between this point to this point, I believe, hey? Yeah, 3.03, right? So this is just a later line. So, you know, pull couple of dimensions to double check, and then you are good. So let's go and try the other one. Place image. So this is when you're placing image without the real coordinate. So line with the distance, as you can see, you do the same kind of idea. Oh, I loaded a underground drawing, so I have more dimensions here. You see like this 80-20. So I'm gonna use the longest, the better, because it's just gonna scale it nicer, right? So from here to here, and now it's asking me for a bearing, right, of this line. So if I say, let's say 0, the whole drawing should be rotated almost 90 degrees. So this line is gonna be on 0, right? So if you look at that, so this line is perfectly now vertical. So that would be another one. And let's do scale bar and known bearing, right? So I'm gonna turn this other one off, I think. Page 3. Okay, so now as you can see, our north arrow is pointing this way. So we're gonna keep this 80-20 for my scaling. I already technically clicked it, but I'm just gonna go one more, boom, from here to here. My bearing is gonna be 0 because my north arrow wants to point up. And now I don't remember, but I think you wanna go from the bottom to the top. hit compute, and from the bottom of north arrow to the top of north arrow, put your bearing in, and you see it rotated now the drawing based on the north arrow. So between the line with the distance and scale bar and north arrow, it's not much of a difference, but the scale bar and bearing is that your distance which you are scaling to is not the same as your bearing, so you have two different. With the line with the bearing is, let's say you had a property line where you have no bearing and no distance, you can scale it based on that. So hope you found it informative. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you next video.